Today we're going to be working on the turbo inlet on the Kia K5 all-wheel drive 1.6 turbo. So as you can see, K&N didn't come with a turbo inlet. It stopped right here at the silencer, and this I believe just kind of reduces the sound of the turbo spinning up, and we'll get to that shortly. So these are the parts we'll be using. This 3-inch pipe from Spectre. We'll have the items in the description. As well as this 3-inch to a 2.5-inch reducer. So first we're gonna take off this bolt here. And then there's another one that's down below it. It's very hard to see. But you might be able to see from this side, it's a little silver down there right underneath the turbo. Let's go ahead and disconnect the negative battery terminal. These are 8mm. In order to get to the one below, we're gonna use this swivel. Okay, the bottom one is a 10mm and it's also a Phillips. And you might need to use a pry bar to move this if it's been a while since you put on your K&N. And you really gotta rock this back and forth and twist to get it to loosen. And then it's out. And we'll just measure the inside. You can see all the baffling in there. So it's hard to see in the camera, but it's about a 1¾ reduction in airflow. This rubber coupler is, it's hard to see, but 2¼ inch. The outside of this is 2.5. And then you count the inner edge is about 2¼. So we'll see how this works. So we can see it's loosely put together. And the size is different. And you can see it sticks out a little bit more. And notice you want to flip the screw or bolt heads just so you could get to it the way you could before. So I'm just measuring the clearance inside. It's a little over an inch, about 1¼ inches, a little less deep that we have to work with. Next, we're gonna test fit just to see how loose or tight this is, to see if we need to go get some more material. And it feels way too loose. So I guess we're going to AutoZone. So I decided to test fit it all together just in case I don't have to make another trip. It looks like it's gonna work. We still need to fix that bottom piece. This I ordered aluminum, but it looks like they sent me chrome. It's polished aluminum. Maybe it's just so polished so well that it looks like chrome, but I'm gonna wrap that with cold wrap later. Okay, back from Harbor Freight and AutoZone. This is what I got. I may or may not use this, depending on how the top coupler fits. See if I can tighten it down to 3 inches versus 3¼. And this is the part number for AutoZone for the pipe. I just went behind the calendar. They're nice enough to let me go back there and pick it up. Okay, before we cut anything, I'm gonna test fit this pipe. Turns out the pipe wouldn't fit with this rubber piece on. So basically down here, I've just got bare aluminum and then test pipe, test fit with this. Okay, it goes on that way. With everything off, doing a quick measurement, we're right at 2¼ inch. With the internals right at about 1¾. So before we cut this, we're gonna go ahead and test fit. We're gonna need to cut a piece about 1 inch or less because there's a ridge right at that turbo inlet junction. So we're gonna test fit this to this. So it is kind of loose. I don't know if you can see here. see if I can get the angle better. So you can see a little gap there that we'll be able to tighten in. And I'll compare it to the previous one. So here's the previous. So you can see a little more gap here from this angle. You can see all that light coming through. That's at least a quarter inch. And then if I marry these two up, again, you can see, yeah, it does have quite a difference here. Okay, here's our custom piece that we just cut. Just be careful with your knife. Got a little lip there I need to trim, but yeah, just like a little one inch piece. Set it next to the other one. See, it's a little bit shorter, but that'll work. Okay, now the next step, and why I bought the pipe cutter, is to measure the outside of this, and then measure the inside of this. That way we can cut the outside of this, the inside. We'll mark everything with a trusty Sharpie, and then get ready to cut. The funny thing is there's an optical illusion. It's measuring right at 8 3/4 on both, which is super strange. But the difference is 5 1/4 on the bottom. And that's where the optical illusion is coming to truth. So it seems like this needs to come more at an angle to match everything up. Maybe the best way to visualize it is up against the wall. And you can kind of see, based off that baseboard, squared up where we're at. Okay, so I decided for the sake of simplicity, I'm just gonna go ahead and cut a 3/4 inch off the entire thing. We'll adjust the space, the coupler over to kind of take care of any issues we might have. Okay, now you can see this is the one that where I cut it. Remember to wear gloves with this, and it is not an easy job. You got to put a lot of force into cutting it, because usually those pipe cutters are used for a full muffler, just cutting a tip off of it. But when there's not much to grab onto, and if you don't have the pipe clamps, it is tricky to cut through that. But with persistence, you can do it. So now, sitting the two pieces together, it seems more at the right length and everything. And now we're gonna go ahead and insert the adapter that we created. Okay, got that on now. Now it's time to add this, but make sure you go ahead and adjust this piece as well, because if you fill in, you can kind of see the depth, and you might need to adjust that just so the ring ends up tightening the correct portion. So you need to pull that out. Go ahead and pull it out and make the adjustment. Just want to point out that I'm using the rough edge on the top, not to go into that reducer. First, I'm tightening this top one to see if I can get it to lock down to a 3 inch without having a leak. Okay, so you can see we adjusted here, pushed everything back a little bit to give it more space, give it more of a lip to catch onto here. I've already done this hard bolt down here. Now I'm just doing the top one. These are 8 mm on the Spectre coupler. Okay, everything's locked down tight. A little closer look. So I got some wrapping to do when I do this pipe as well. But next step is to see what it sounds like. So no check engine light. Okay, so why not just go with the Shark Racing intake? Well, the main reason was this box. Shark Racing hasn't made a box yet to go with theirs, and living in West Texas, you get a lot of dust and sand, and you don't want that all clogging up these filters, so you want to kind of keep all that separate and keep it clean. Make sure you check for all your intake leaks, but I already checked all that. That's it. I recommend you save all your OEM intake and exhaust parts just in case you ever need to get rid of your car.